Let us all stand. Let us pray. Lord God, you loved this world so much that you gave your one and only Son, that we might be called your children too. Lord, help us to live in the gladness and the grace of Easter Sunday every day. Let us have hearts to thankfulness for your sacrifice. Let us have eyes that look upon your grace and rejoice in our salvation. Help us to walk in that mighty grace and tell your good news to the world. All for your glory do we pray, Lord. Amen. Let us all sing together hymn number 158 from the hymn book. 158.
Amen. Please be seated. Now the first and second lesson will be read.
Today's first lesson is taken from Isaiah chapter 60 verses 12 to 21. Isaiah chapter 60 verses 12 to 21. For the nation or kingdom that will not serve you will perish. It will be utterly ruined. The glory of Lebanon will come to you. The juniper, the fir, and the cypress together to adorn my sanctuary, and I will glorify the place for my feet. The children of your oppressors will come bowing before you. All who despise you will bow down at your feet and will call you the city of the Lord, Zion of the Holy One of Israel. Although you have been forsaken and hated, with no one traveling through, I will make you the everlasting pride and the joy of all generations. You will drink the milk of nations and be nursed at royal breasts. Then you will know that I, the Lord, am your Savior, your Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob. Instead of bronze, I'll bring you gold and silver in place of iron. Instead of wood, I bring you bronze and iron in place of stones. I will make peace your governor and well-being your ruler. No longer will violence be heard in your land, nor ruin or destruction within your borders, but you will call your walls salvation and your gates praise. The sun will no more be your light by day, nor will the brightness of the moon shine on you. For the Lord will be your everlasting light, and your God will be your glory. Your sun will never set again, and your moon will wane no more. The Lord will be your everlasting light, and your days of sorrow will end. Then all your people will be righteous, and they will possess the land forever. They are the shoot I have planted, the work of my hands, for the display of my splendor. Here ends the first lesson.
The second lesson is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 42 to 58. 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 42 to 58. So will it be with the resurrection of the dead. The body that is sown is perishable. It is raised imperishable. It is sown in dishonor. It is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness. It is raised in power. It is sown a natural body. It is raised a spiritual body. If there is a natural body, there is also a spiritual body. So it is written, the first man Adam became a living being. The last Adam gave a life-giving spirit. The spiritual did not come first, but the natural, and after that the spiritual. The first man was of the dust of the earth. The second man is of heaven. As was the earthly man, so are those who are of the earth. And as is the heavenly man, so are also those who are of the heaven. And just as we have borne the image of the earthly man, so shall we bear the image of the heavenly man. I declare to you, brothers and sisters, that the flesh and blood cannot be inherit in the kingdom of God, nor does the perishable inherit the imperishable. Listen, I tell you a mystery. We will not all sleep, but we will all be changed. In the flash, in the twinkling of an eye, at the trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed. For the perishable must clothe itself with the imperishable, and the mortal with the immortality. When the perishable has been clothed with the imperishable, the mortal with immortality, then the saying is written will come true. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, He gives us the victory to our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, stand firm, let nothing move you. Always give yourself fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. Here ends the second lesson.
Jesus Christ, born of Mary, baptized by John, have mercy on us.
We magnify you, O Lord our King, only begotten Son, God the Father, Lord Jesus Christ, immortal in nature, who was born of the Virgin Mary, for the life and salvation of all mankind. Without change of nature, you became the Son of Man and are crucified for us. And destroying it forever. You are born in the Holy Trinity and are worshipped and glorified equally with the Father and the living and Holy Spirit. Have mercy on us.
Holy art thou, O God.
Holy art thou, Almighty Lord.
Holy art thou, immortal Lord. Holy art thou, O God.
Holy art thou, Almighty Lord.
Holy art thou, immortal Lord.
O thou crucified for us, have mercy on us.
Holy art thou, O God.
Holy art thou, Almighty Lord.
Holy art thou, immortal Lord.
O thou crucified for us, have mercy on us.
The blessed Apostle Paul says, If we ourselves or an angel from heaven should preach a gospel at variance with the gospel we preach to you, he shall be held outcast. Various kinds of teaching spring up in all quarters, For blessed is he who begins and ends in the teaching of God.
Accept, O Lord, these our prayers and petitions. Make us to observe in purity and goodness of heart your precepts and those of your holy apostles and of your apostle Paul, architect and builder of your church.
From the Epistle of Paul to 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 20 to 28. But Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruit of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead comes also through a man. For as in Adam all die, so in Christ all will be made alive. But each in turn, Christ the first fruits, then when he comes, those who belong to him. Then the end will come when the hands over the kingdom of God the Father, after he has destroyed all dominion, authority and power, for he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death, for he has put everything under his feet. Now when it says that everything he has put under him, it is clear that this does not include God himself, who put everything under Christ. When he has done this, the Son himself will be made subject to him, who put everything under him, so that God may be in all. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Offer to the Lord sacrifice of praise. Come and worship in his holy courts.
Give to us knowledge and discernment of your divine word. Fill us with the truth of your holy gospel, the riches of your wisdom, and the gift of your spirit. Enable us gladly to obey your commands and perfectly to fulfill your holy will. Make us worthy to receive your blessings and mercies at all times, now and forever.
Amen. Brethren, let us stand in silence and reverence and listen to the proclamation of the living word of God from the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Peace be with you all.
And with you also, may the Lord make us all worthy to listen to his word.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, which proclaims life and salvation to the world, as recorded by Evangelist Luke.
Blessed is he that comes and will come again. Praise to the Father who sent him for our salvation. May his blessing be ever upon us.
In the days of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, Word of Life, God incarnate of the Blessed Virgin Mary, it happened in this way.
So we believe and affirm.
But on the first day of the week, at early dawn, they came to the tomb, taking the spices they had prepared. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb, but when they went in, they did not find the body. While they were perplexed about this, suddenly two men in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. But the men said to them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee, that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners and be crucified, and on the third day he will rise again." Then they remembered his words, and returning from the tomb, they told all this to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary, the mother of James, and other women with whom who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to them a little tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter got up and ran to the tomb. Stooping and looking in, he saw the linen clothes by themselves. Then he went home, amazed at what had happened. Peace be with you all.
And with you also. We thank you, Lord, that you have your gospel. Be the light of the world. That we may be drawn closer to you. In the enable us by your grace to give praise to you, the living words of your gospel, which we have in the hand of
O Lord, grant us your grace and your mercy.
Merciful Lord, have mercy and help us.
Help us, O Lord, continually to offer to you our praise and thanksgiving to him who absolves us from all our debts and pardons our sins and receives the penitent and makes him holy, who earns for the redemption of sinners and promised, call and I will answer, knock and I will open and stretch forth my hand to pardon your sins. To you belong glory and honor and worship now and forever.
Amen. Merciful Lord, have mercy and help us.
O Lord God, who alone can make holy, who alone can pardon and remove our sins, blot out my many, great, and innumerable sins, and those of all your people. O Lord, in your goodness, have mercy on us and bless us. O Lord, remember us and our families, our bishops and clergy, and all the faithful members of your holy church. Strengthen us, we pray, in body and spirit. Ever refresh us with your grace and mercy. Save us from all evil and lead us as your children to dwell with you forever. May we grow in grace and in knowledge of you. To you we offer praise and thanksgiving forever and ever.
Amen.
O Lord God, mighty and glorious, save us by your power from the wiles of the evil one. O Lord, in your grace and mercy and love for mankind, you took flesh of the Blessed Virgin Mary and were born as man among men. Do not banish us, O Lord, from your presence and from the company of the angels and archangels, the seraphim and cherubim, and all who serve and adore your holy name. Show to us the way of life and salvation, that we may persevere and attend to your glorious kingdom, ever praising your goodness and bounty towards us. Lord Jesus, look upon us with the eye of your mercy. Save us from all that would hurt us and keep us in the shadow of your cross. Lord Jesus, free us from all evil and defilement and enrich us from the treasury of your bountiful mercy. Lord Jesus, make us to rejoice and to partake in your glory with all you have served you. And to you and to the Father and to the Holy Spirit we ascribe all praise and thanksgiving now and forever.
Amen.
Weak and sinful as we are, let us confess and together say, Holy is the Holy Father.
Amen.
Holy is the Holy Son.
Amen.
Holy is the living and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Wisdom cries aloud, let us stand in reverence and affirm together.
We believe in one true God, the Father Almighty.
The only
begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father,
before all worlds.
Light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary and was made man. He was crucified also for us in the day of Pontius Pilate, suffered and died and was buried. The third day he rose again by his Father's holy will, ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge both the living and the dead, and of his kingdom there will be no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets and apostles. We believe one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge the baptism of the Holy Spirit, and look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the new life of the world to come. Amen.
Be seated. Grace and peace to you from God our Father, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing that comes from heaven, who knew you and chose you before the world began, who loves you so much that he calls you his own children. Now the time for the birthday and wedding anniversary Thanksgiving prayer. Those who celebrate their birthdays or wedding anniversary in this tree, please come forward for the Thanksgiving prayer.
Let us pray. Our Lord, Heavenly, gracious Father, once again we thank you for giving us this beautiful morning, this Easter Sunday morning, to come before your mighty name and to bow down our heads and to give praise. Lord, you have been a good Father to all of us. You have granted all the good blessings of this life to each one of us. Lord, we kindly uphold all those who are celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries these days. Lord, you have granted them all the good blessings and they are grateful as they come before you. Lord, kindly accept the praises, the oblations, and the sacrifices. Lord, bless them with the new year, with all your grace and blessings. Lord, in their workplaces, in their studies, in their family life, Lord, kindly be with them and bless them with all the goodness. Lord, as they come through a lot of trials and temptations, Lord, kindly beseech your everlasting grace upon each one of them, so that they can come out of every trials and temptations by getting the strength in your holy name. Lord, we pray for all those who are celebrating birthdays. Lord, kindly be with them and guide them. Lord, we pray for all those who are celebrating their wedding anniversaries. Bless their families, bless their children and grandchildren. Lord, help them to grow in that right spirit. Lord, be with them and guide them. Lord, we especially pray for all those who can't make for this service today, this morning. Lord, as they are at homes, kindly be with them and guide them. Bless them with all your goodness. Lord, we bless. Kindly ask for your blessings for each and everyone. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Lord, your blessing.
because those who have received answers for their prayers and have received blessings and mercies last week, and those who have any special prayer request, please come forward for the Thanksgiving prayer. Pray to you, O Lord. I lift up my soul, O my God, in your I trust. Do not let me put to shame. Do not let my enemies exult over me. Lord, we submit these children of yours into your hands. Lord, some are offering their thanks to you as you have heard their cries. As a worshiping community, we all praise and glorify you for being with them in this trouble, in their trouble, distress and agony. Give them the confidence that you are always with them. Help them to lead a life pleasing to you. Lord, we submit all those who have special prayer requests. We do not know for what matter they are worried, but you can see their hearts. Lord, console them. Strengthen them with your power of resurrection. It is you who told your disciples that you will go ahead of them to Galilee. So you are always going ahead of us. Help us to strongly believe that. Help us to be strong in our faith that we are worshiping a God who is alive and not dead. Answer their prayers, Lord. Heal them in their body, mind, and spirit. Give them your peace, which passes all understanding. In Jesus' precious name we pray. On 6th April, that is next Tuesday, at 10:30 a.m., there will be Saviour Sangha meeting through WebEx. On 7th April, that is next Wednesday, at 5:30 p.m., there will be Edo Mission meeting through WebEx. On next Friday morning, 10 a.m., fasting prayer meeting through WebEx. Next Saturday, that is second Saturday, that is 10th April, at morning 8 o'clock, Holy Kurbana in Malayalam at our church. Next Sunday, morning 7 a.m., Holy Kurbana in Malayalam, 9 a.m., Holy Kurbana Malayalam in Hosur, and 10 a.m., Matin service in English. The general body meeting of the Martama Yuvadana Sakyam of our parish will be conducted after the morning service at the church on 11th April 2021, that is next Sunday at 9 a.m. All the UN Sakyam members are requested to attend the annual general body meeting. Next Sunday onwards, area prayer meetings will be started after the Lent season. Next Sunday, we will have prayer meetings at Vivek Nagar at 4 p.m., Koramangala at 4 p.m., and Madiwala at 7 p.m. All our parish members are requested to attend in their respective area prayer meetings. Marriage ban announcement. The marriage of Mr. Mrudun Matthew, son of Mrs. Sarama Matthew, and Mr. Matthew Thomas, belong to the Madiwala prayer group, and Miss Ansi Babichan Thayil, daughter of late Mrs. Rosamma Antony and Mr. Babu Thomas. They belong to the St. Jude the Catholic Church, Udayanagar, Narayanapura, Bangalore. It is decided to be held on 10th April Saturday, that is next Saturday, at 4 p.m. at the Mathoma Syrian Church, Primrose Road, Bangalore. If there is any impediments against the conducting of the above marriage, may please intimate the vicar in writing as early as possible. Now the choir will lead the hymn number 203 from the hymn book. At that time, the offertory will be taken.
Give thanks to God, our Lord, Heavenly Father. Once again, we thank you for giving us all the goodness from your divine grace. Lord, we thank you for the offertories that we have offered in front of you. Lord, as we try to offer ourselves in front of you, Lord, kindly accept these offertories and bless each one of us. Lord, we pray for each and every family of this church, for all those who have come today in this Easter Sunday morning and bowed their heads in your mighty name. Lord, kindly be with them and guide them with all the blessings. Lord, we pray for all those who are at home. Lord, kindly be with them. Lord, kindly make use of these offerings for the building of thy kingdom. Lord, kindly bless each one of us, our church, our society, and each and every one. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
For our short reflection, I would like to have your attention on the gospel portion, that is gospel according to St. Luke chapter 24 verses 1 to 12. The theme for today's reflection is resurrection, celebrating the joy of salvation. Resurrection, celebrating the joy of salvation. Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you for your Son, who is resurrection and life. Embolden us to be firm in our faith. Empower us to go beyond the boundaries to love and serve. And enlighten us to recognize the risen Lord in the untrodden paths of our life. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, a rock and our redeemer. Amen. The early Christian proclamation of the risen Lord depended fundamentally on the four Gospels. That is in Matthew chapter 28, Mark chapter 16, Luke chapter 24, and Gospel according to St. John chapter 20 and 21. When we look into the epistles, 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 5 to 7, says that Jesus appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time. St. Paul predominantly underlines his own witness in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 1, 15, verse 8, Galatians chapter 1, verses 12 and 16, where he attests that the risen Jesus appeared both to various individuals and groups of witness, and so more particular to the 11 disciples. The witness of Jesus' resurrection makes the disciples as apostles and in a unique manner as the choicest of the earth. While we look into our gospel portion, it is written in verses 1 and 2, but on the first day of the week, at early dawn, they went to the tomb, taking the spices they had prepared, and they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. So I want to share three small points about the fact of the empty tomb. Firstly, the fact of the empty tomb, the center of Christian faith. The fact of the empty tomb, the center of Christian faith. If the tomb were not empty, the centrality of Jerusalem would not have been maintained for a single day in the history. Faith in the crucified and risen Jesus cannot exist without the historical knowledge. Saint Peter, in his charismatic speech, as recorded in Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verses 32, he says, God raised this man, Jesus, to life, and all of us are witness to that. And further, he qualifies in verses 36, God had made this Jesus, whom you crucified, both Lord and Christ. This primordial event remains a concrete reality which divided the history as Christ-centered history. But coalescing that, the divine and human histories, thus making the Christ fulfilled history and the Christ controlled history. It is this Christic event dictated the history as before and after Christ, as the decisive and a beautiful moment. Confidently looking at the all 11 apostles, added up with Saint Paul and the host of the saints in the first two centuries, would not have been sacrificed their lives as martyrs, but for the resurrection of Jesus. The Christic event could not contain the power of God within the grave. The glorious tombs of all other prophets were found closed, but the tomb of Jesus remained open ever as the unhealed wound on the earth. Therefore, the fact of empty tomb becomes both as the reality and a constructive hope of the life for eternity. Secondly, the fact of the empty tomb, celebration of hope and life. The fact of the empty tomb, celebration of hope and life. The eschatological hope that Jesus' resurrection brings in an ethical change for believers. The Pauline faith in the divide of flesh, that is, social and life, means physical and spiritual. The resurrection is believed as the power, that is in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verses 56 and 57, over sin. To live in the resurrection, power over the sin through Jesus Christ is always possible for the one who is in Christ. That is in Romans chapter 6 verses 11. As Paul says, so if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away, and see, everything has become new. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 verses 17. This indicates the continued faith journey of the believers beyond death, as it is said, that is in 1 Peter chapter 3 verses 18. Jesus Christ, the first fruit of new creation, Jesus' resurrection involves a hope of salvation, while death of Jesus on the cross for the sake of the world. In other words, the righteous dying for the unrighteousness. The death of Jesus must be understood always in the context of Jesus' resurrection. John in his gospel put that God loved the world by sending Jesus to save the world. John chapter 3 verses 16 and 17. The Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. Therefore, if we have been united with him in a death like this, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like this also. That is in Romans chapter 6 verses 5. This hope in Christ's resurrection is always a celebration of believers. Thirdly, the fact of the empty tomb as the experience in resurrected Lord. The fact of the empty tomb as the experience in resurrected Lord. The path of sharing and growing in Easter faith has become possible by experiencing the risen Christ in worship with others, much more than analyzing evidence in favor of the resurrection. It has been a matter of knowing the risen Christ in direct and lasting experience rather than knowing things. It enjoys a practical as well as a logical spiritual credibility. Resurrection faith claims not only that Jesus rose from the dead, but also that through the power of the Holy Spirit, he has remained actively present in the world and in particular in the lives of all the believers. Thus, the personal experience in the resurrection of Jesus can be appeared with that of the primordial experience of Moses' burning bush or Jacob's peniel like this. This experience leads us to understand the divine self-revelation. In other words, this experience of God encountering that dispels the darkness both in the mind and life. This gives a new vision and a perspective towards changing our identity and the behavior as found in the case of St. Paul's personal experience on the road to Damascus. However, the church always celebrates Easter experience in the breaking of bread as in the experience of the two disciples at Emmaus, how they found their eyes opened and knew their risen Lord as the divine encounter. That is in Luke chapter 24, verses 30 and 31. And their experience of breakfast together on the lakeside, the disciples knew that it was the Lord. The climax, of course, comes in the experience of Thomas in his confession of a unique faith in the resurrected Lord as my Lord and my God. Yet another divine encounter. As John concludes it in the climactic statement, exhorting believers to come, that is in John chapter 20, verses 29. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe. They are blessed who believe in the experience, the risen Christ, who even if he remains invisible, is truly present and disclosed to them. Let me conclude this short reflection. Christian witness, too, should not merely attempt to share an experience, rather it should direct people to Jesus so that people can encounter him for themselves. The risen Lord encounters us in our daily life situations. He liberates us and empowers us to realize the vision of God to affirm the life and glory and dignity of every person created in the likeness and image of God and to proclaim the ultimate truth. May the power of the risen Lord embolden us to confront the challenges and move forward to be a light in the darkness and sort that loses its identity in order to transform others. Christ is risen. Hallelujah.
Let us pray. Lord God, thank you that death could not hold Christ, but gave way to your power and authority. Thank you for this great good news that brings light out of the darkness. Thank you that you did not leave Jesus in the grave, but raised him up for our sakes. Thank you that we know that eternal life is real because Christ himself rose from the grave as the forerunner of what is to come. Thank you that sin and death are defeated by the resurrection of Christ. Raise men up to new life in him. Heavenly Father, thank you for the word of God and the gracious truth that it contains. Thank you, God, for Santosh Achan, who delivered us your word. Thank you for his ministry in us throughout these years. Lord, lead us this worship as a blessing for us. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Now the time of the confession. Those who have come prepared to join the Holy Kurbana may stand up and repeat the confession prayer after me. I confess that I have sinned against you, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, in thought, word, and deed. I am sorry with all my heart for these my sins. I believe in your promise that you will receive those who truly repent. O Lord, who are merciful and full of grace, accept me even as you accept the publican, the woman who was a sinner, and the thief on the cross, and comfort me by the consolation of your word. O Lord, grant that your holy body and holy blood, in which I now partake, may not bring me to judgment and condemnation, but to life and wholeness. Amen. May God Almighty be compassionate to you, who have truly confessed your sins and freely forgive your sins, and make you worthy to partake in this holy Kurbana. Amen.
Beloved brethren, pray with me that this service may be acceptable to the Lord.
O Lord, we humbly knock at your door. Come into your house, we pray for your blessing. Sanctify your servant by your truth. O Lord, we call upon you in faith. Remember your promise, where two or three are met in your name, you are there in their midst. Impart your servant spiritual gifts. Send your Holy Spirit who dwelt in the apostles to make his dwelling in us your people.
O God and Lord of all, make us worthy to greet one another with the kiss of peace, freed from insincerity and united in love. To you, O Father, and to your only Son, And to your Holy Spirit we ascribe praise and glory, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with you also. In the love of the Lord, let us greet one another in peace. Peace of our Lord Jesus Christ abide with us forever. May the love and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ abide with us forever. Brethren, having received this token of peace, let us bow our heads before the merciful Lord. Gracious Lord, we bow before you.
Merciful Lord, you dwell on high, yet condescend to look upon things that are lowly. Bless now those who have bowed their heads in your presence, and bless them with the grace of your only Son, with whom and with the Holy Spirit you are worthy of all praise and glory, now and forever.
Amen. Brethren, with reverence and purity of heart, with love and true faith and devotion, let us participate in this Holy Kurbana which is now offered. To God the Father, to whom all things belong, is offered this sacrifice of grace, peace, and praise in a spirit of unity and concord.
The love of God the Father, the grace of only begotten Son, the communion and abiding presence of the Holy Spirit be with you all, dearly beloved, now and forever.
With you also.
May our hearts be with Christ on high.
Hearts truly are with the Lord.
To sing praises and worship the Creator of all things.
Assuredly is good and right.
Who is adored by the heavenly host, sun and moon and all the stars, the earth and seas and all that dwell there, angels and archangels, thrones and powers, cherubim and seraphim, ever proclaiming.
Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Heaven and earth are full of His glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is He who has come and is to come in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
When the sinless one of His own will chose to suffer death for us sinners, He took bread in His holy hand.
Bless, O Lord.
He gave thanks, sanctified, and broke it and gave it to His apostles, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. This do in remembrance of me."
Amen.
In the same way, He took the cup.
Bless, O Lord.
He gave thanks, blessed, sanctified, and gave it to His apostles, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many for the forgiveness of sins." As often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes.
Your death, O Lord, we commemorate. Your resurrection we celebrate. In the second coming we await. May Your blessing rest upon us all.
O Lord, we remember Your death, burial and resurrection, Your ascension into heaven, and Your presence now with God the Father in glory and in power. We await Your coming again to judge the world in righteousness and truth. Therefore, we, Your people, offer to You, O Lord, this service and sacrifice, entreating You and through You, Your Father, not to deal with us according to our sins, but according to Your own abundant mercy, and saying,
"Have mercy on us, O Lord our God. We give thanks to You, we praise You, we glorify You, we worship You. Have mercy on us and bless us."
Answer unto us, O Lord. Answer unto us, O Lord. Answer unto us, O Lord, and by your grace have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
May the Holy Spirit sanctify this bread, that it may be the body of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit sanctify the wine in this chalice, that it may be the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Sanctify, O Lord, the bodies and souls of those who receive these gifts, that they may bear fruit for the stability of your holy church. Establish ever more firmly your church founded on the rock of faith, against which the gates of hell shall not prevail, and preserve her to the end from strife and error. To you, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, we will offer praise and thanksgiving, both now and forever.
Amen.
Look with mercy, O Lord, on your holy church throughout the world, on all the bishops who bear the burden of leading and guiding her, especially our Father in God, the Valiya Metropolitan, the Metropolitan, the Moderators, CNI and CSI, our bishops, priests and deacons. Give to each one your Holy Spirit, that they may diligently work in your vineyard.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, all our loved ones, those here present with us and those who have not been able to join us. Answer the prayers as you know to be best. Remember, O Lord, all true and faithful followers of Christ, and give them the help and support of your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, all who exercise authority in our country and society, especially the president and all who hold offices in the state. Help them to put their trust in you and to seek from you wisdom and spiritual strength. Implant in them the will to do good and the spirit of cooperation, and guide them in all their deliberations and decisions.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, in the last day, will you raise and gather all the faithful who are departed and fallen asleep in the true faith. Grant that we also may with them be counted worthy of the remission of our sins and be gathered into heavenly kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
The blessing of our God and Savior, Jesus Christ, be with you all now and forever.
And with you also.
Brethren, with one heart and mind, let us pray to the Lord for peace and reconciliation, for unity in the church, and harmony between all peoples and communities.
We pray to the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
We pray to the Lord.
For consolation for the bereaved, relief for the poor and needy, shelter for the homeless, joy for the brokenhearted.
We pray to the Lord.
Let us give glory to God the Father, Lord of all, and worship His only begotten Son, and praise His holy and life-giving Spirit.
O Lord of all blessings, we commit our lives into keeping and pray for your blessing. O God, good and gracious, have mercy on us and bless us.
Let us spend a few moments for our intercessory prayers. Our Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for giving us this great Easter Sunday morning. Lord, this Sunday morning marks the victory of life over the death, and you are the true life. Lord, we seek you. Kindly be with us and guide us. Lord, in this pandemic times, we are going through tough days ahead. Lord, we find all these places under protocols. Lord, but you have given us the great strength and all the blessings so that we can come together in this Sunday morning and to worship you in truth and spirit in this holy church. Lord, we thank you for all the blessings. Lord, we thank you for all the members who have turned out in this Sunday morning to attend this service. Lord, as they come before you with a contrite heart, Lord, kindly be with them and guide them with all your blessings. Lord, they ask you, they seek you, and they knock at your door. Kindly open, kindly let them find you. Kindly let them come into you and ever have that grace to enjoy the life in you. Lord, we pray for all our needs. You are a merciful Father who knows all our needs. Still, Lord, you ask us to pray. Lord, we pray for all those who are sick, those who are in hospitals, those who are recovering from various illnesses. Lord, kindly be with them and guide them. Give them the desired health so that they can ever proclaim your mighty name. Lord, we pray for Vargis Abrahangal, Lilikutty Aunty, Tangamani Aunty, James Philip Chan, Saji Philip Chan, and our PC Matayangal. Lord, be with them and guide them. Give them the good health so they can ever proclaim your mightiest name. Lord, we pray for Abraham Raju Uncle, who is recovering after operation. Kindly be with him and guide them. Lord, we pray for all the families who are undergoing the pain of bereavement. Kindly be with them. Kindly help them with your divine grace. Lord, we pray for our children, those who are studying in schools and colleges, who are staying abroad, those who are searching for jobs, those who are writing exams, those who want to get admissions into desired colleges. Lord, be with them and guide them. Help them to get whatever they wish in your name. Be with them. Lord, we pray for all those who are going to enter into family life. Lord, we pray for those who are in family life. Kindly help them to understand each other. Live a family life centered on the Christ. Lord, we pray for parents who are sick, those who are senior citizens. Lord, as they are confined to their home, kindly give them the true honor and glory as they feel refreshed in your mighty name. Lord, we pray for each and every family of this parish, those who are scattered in and around the city. Kindly be with each and every individual. Lord, not let one of them be lost. Lord, you are a good shepherd. You know your sheep by their name. As you call out our name, help us listen to your voice and come unto your fold. Lord, we pray for our Sabha, for our respected bishops, our clergy, our evangelists, our Sabha people. Lord, be with them and guide them. Lord, we especially pray for our church, those all who are serving in our church, especially our dear Charlie Achan, Santosh Achan, Joseph Ayurkudi Achan. Lord, be with them and guide them as families and bless them with all thy divine blessings. Lord, we pray for all the office bearers of this church. Lord, we pray for all the institutions of this church. Kindly be with each and every thing and every individual. Lord, help us to communicate the true faith in the Easter Sunday morning. Help us to rejoice in the shadow of your everfold grace, that we can say we have won victory over death. Lord, we pray for our country, especially for those states which are preparing themselves for the elections. Lord, kindly be with each and every individual in government level, administrative level. Kindly help them to cast everything very well in your name. Lord, we pray for the countries in and around India. Especially, we pray for the eradication of this COVID-19. Lord, as the vaccination process are going through. But still, Lord, we come to know that a lot of people are getting affected because of this COVID. Lord, we kindly seek your guidance, your protection under your wings, so that we can be ever protected by all these harms and all these evils. Lord, as we're going to start a new week, kindly be with us and guide us in our travelings, in our prayers, in our worship, in our day-to-day activities. Kindly be with us. Lord, we uphold all those who have bowed their heads in your mighty name. Lord, kindly bless them with all your blessings. We pray for all those who are at home. Lord, be with them and guide them with your blessings. Lord, we uphold all our needs in your mighty name. Let us spend a few moments for all these our needs. In Jesus' precious name we pray.
Amen.
O God, the Father of Lord Jesus Christ, glorified by the cherubim, exalted by the seraphim, and extolled by all the heavenly hosts, who make holy the offerings and oblations presented before you, sanctify our bodies, souls, and spirits, that with pure and confident hearts we may address you.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, may your kingdom come, may your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day the bread we need, and forgive us our sins and offenses as we have forgiven those who offended us. Do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with you also. O Lord and God of every blessing, we bow heads in your presence before we receive your holy body and blood.
May the grace and mercy of holy and glorious Trinity, uncreated, self-existent, eternal, adorable, and one in essence be with you all, dearly beloved, now and forever.
And with you also, holy and glorious Trinity, have mercy on us.
Holy things for holy people.
Holy is the one Father, holy is the one Son, holy is the one Spirit.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
One from the beginning and forever and ever. Amen.
The one Holy Father who created the world in His mercy is with us.
Amen.
The one Holy Son who saved it is by precious passion is with us.
Amen.
The one living Holy Spirit who perfects and fulfills all that is and that has been is with us. May the name of the Lord be blessed as in the beginning, both now and forever. Beloved brethren, pray for me.
As the Father has compassion on his sons, the Lord has pity on those who fear him. As for man, his days are like grass, he flies like the flowers of the field.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be. Amen. A living voice rouses from the grave, your servants who have departed this life in trust and hope in you, then, O Lord, remember us.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, grant that we may rejoice with all those who have done your will and hear your gracious words. Come and inherit the kingdom with the saints.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. O Lord, at your command, death held its sway. You rose from the dead, and death was abolished. Therefore, O Lord, we praise and exult. O Lord, every mouth shall sing your praise. You gather your children from every quarter. Bless us and help us, we pray you, O Lord. O Son of God, by your death you have turned our death into life. Raise us from the dust that we have proclaimed your praise. May God the Father, the Son, and the Spirit, whose worthy of glory and worship forever, be praised from generation to generation. Alleluia.
O Son of God, who came for our salvation, and will come again for our resurrection and for the renewal of our grace, grant, we pray, forgiveness of sins to your servants through your own atoning sacrifice.
Amen.
O Lord God, graciously bless these children who partake of your most precious body and blood, which was given on Calvary for the forgiveness of sins, so that they may abide in your presence forever.
Amen.
The blessings of Jesus Christ, our great God and Savior, be on those who bear the sacred mysteries, on those who dispense them, on those who receive them, and on all who have participated and who shall participate in them. The grace of God be on us all, both now and forever.
Amen. Lord, be gracious and have mercy on us. Glory and praise be to you, O Lord. Praise be to your everlasting refuge.
The holy body and blood of Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, broken and shed on the cross of Calvary, for the forgiveness of sins, is given to each one of you for the health of your body and soul. Amen.
Thank you.
forever. Praise be to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. May your holy body and blood, which we have now partaken, be not for a condemnation, but for life and salvation to our soul. O Lord, grant us your blessing.
All the earth shall bow down before you, and every tongue shall praise your holy name. For you give life to the dead, and the hope of all will lie in the grave. We praise you, O Lord, and give you thanks for your mercy towards us.
We praise you, O Lord, because in your abundant mercy, you have fed and strengthened us with the precious body and blood of your Son and Savior, Jesus Christ. And you have thereby made us one with him and with all the members of his mystical body. We pray you to give us grace to continue in that holy fellowship and ever to offer glory and praise to you and to your only begotten Son and to your Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with you also. O Lord our God, throw the fall blessings. We bow heads before you and receive your holy body and blood.
O great and wonderful God, who for the salvation of mankind stooped down and descended from heaven, have mercy on us and bless us, so that we may continually praise you and the Father and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, bless us all. O Creator, keep us all. Show us ever the way of salvation. O Lord and Helper of all.
O Lord, bless your servant who has ministered in your holy presence. Accept the praise and petitions of us, your people, and pardon our offenses. Enable us to receive the gifts and blessings, and dismiss us with your peace.
My beloved brethren, I commend you to the grace and blessings of Holy and Glorious Trinity. Depart in peace with the gifts and blessings that you have received from the atoning sacrifice of the Lord. You both near and far, who are saved by the victorious cross of the Lord and sealed with the seal of holy baptism, this Holy Trinity will forgive you your sins and comfort your soul. Pray for me, my brethren, weak and sinful as I am, so that we may obtain mercy and help. Depart in peace, filled with gladness and rejoicing.
Thanks be to God. May the Lord accept your ministration and help us by your prayers.
Two boxes kept outside. One is for the Rasisa, which is our subscription for the Marthoma Sapha. Each mature individual have to give rupees 1. Count the numbers of mature individuals in your house and deposit in that box. And second one is our devotion and dedication we observe throughout the Lent period by denying food and other things and thereby supporting an amount entirely for the mission work of our church. This is our tradition and deposit that amount prayerfully for the mission work. Jesus is risen, hallelujah. May the power of the hope of resurrection fill our life so that we will be able to rise above the present perils of life in the world. Thank you and God bless you all.
Happy you are talking to both of your kids. Big kids. Okay.